Welcome to 5 Games 5 Minutes from acornelectron.co.uk. In Citadel, your task is to find 5 crystals and, one by one, bring them to an island. To access the crystals, you'll need to map a very colourful castle, teeming with aliens, trampolines, cauldrons, fires and magical items. Citadel is a legend in Acorn Electron world, a game which seemed to define a genre all of its own. The genre in question is the graphic adventure, in which you make progress by finding items in one room, such as keys, and using them with other items, such as doors, in another room. Essentially, that's what Citadel is, at its heart. There's no linear structure to the game. The player can wander into whichever rooms he wishes. Oh, and you can play as male or female too. There is a lot of variety to certain rooms which come alive. Even in the opening locations, you get a room full of sliding blocks, and in another room, a bad guy who homes in on your position. Citadel is an amazing achievement on the Electron, a big, tough puzzle which will challenge everyone. Despatch Rider puts you in charge of Dick Decker on a Yamazaki 750, with no other aim in life than to clear 7 streets of ramps, puddles, and petrol cans. The action is viewed from the side on, and the all-important petrol meter is set conspicuously in the centre of the screen. You're advised to drive like a bat out of hell for the majority of the time, although you can slow down and speed up if you need to negotiate any particularly tricky obstacles. Otherwise, simple tapping of the up and down keys is enough to clear many of the blocks that litter the path. Crashing into cones or puddles loses a life, as does letting the petrol run out. Note that petrol cans top up the meter, but don't disappear when you pick them up. The first street is easy, but the difficulty level soon starts increasing. Despatch Rider reacts well, and it's not a bad little game at all. TOMCAT is a testament to style over substance, as Paul's screenshots of it look incredible. The idea, which probably seemed pretty sound at the time, was to bring the wow factor of the 16-bit machines to the humble Electron. This might work to a certain extent too, because you can't help but marvel at the amount of work that's gone into the graphics. Indeed, you've never seen a shoot 'em up quite like this. It's almost like Fire Track, but in green screen, squashed into half its playing area, and with a much bigger craft. Marvellous! Until, when it's moving, you realise your eyes can't pick out from the details the essential, important elements of a shoot 'em up. Aw man, TOMCAT, it's jerky and slow, and to progress you need to learn the layouts of the entire level. You can't fly in line with nasties either, meaning you're either shooting slightly to their right or not at them at all. Once you fly past them, you can't hit them anymore, but they can still shoot you. I'll give it one thing though, it's a brave attempt to do something different. Shark is the name of the crack commandor who, according to the blurb, was just asked by the world president himself to overrun several sites taken over by guerrilla rebels. And, without further ado, you're launched into the jungle mission. Shark the man moves with some agility and can jump around the playing area making use of branches to get out of the way of incoming enemy fire. The enemy soldiers can do exactly the same as well, and in addition, they have helicopters and jeeps at their disposal. A different number of hits is needed by Shark on different foes to neutralise them. One thing to watch out for is that the explosion of a jeep or a soldier is also fatal to Shark, so just hang back for a few seconds before trying to run through it. At the end of each mission, there's a big boss to defeat before the next mission begins. Mission 1 is relatively easy, but on mission 2 it's difficult to even get off the first screen. Shark is a nice game, colourful and action-packed. It's a shame that it slows down according to how many enemies are on screen. Gremlins is a text adventure based on the Steven Spielberg movie of the same name, and you need pretty good knowledge of that movie in order to make any progress in it. The central premise, although it's not explained by the instructions, is that you came home with a new pet. This pet, a Mogwai, is a sort of alien host and lays eggs that turn into mutant gremlins. The game starts with the gremlins all over your kitchen and the Mogwai hiding in the rubbish chute. You wouldn't know any of this without having seen the movie, of course. Nor would you know that your dad's an inventor, so that remote control might come in handy to kill them. Sorry, but if you're going to write a game like that, it has to come with a copy of the movie and adequate instructions on how to play. Simple as that. We also hate text adventures where death is random, and that's also very much in evidence here. So I'm afraid this lackluster Gremlins tie-in gets a thumbs down, although fans of the movie might find it interesting.